Hi everyone, in this tutorial we're going to create a lightbox gallery using the code override provided at pixcodedrops.com, which you can find the link in the description for. You can see when we hover over the thumbnail images, a magnifying glass icon appears, indicating there is a zoom functionality. And when we click an image, we see that image bigger. We can also zoom in and out using the buttons at the bottom or using the plus and minus keys on the keyboard. We can also use the button in the middle to zoom back to the initial size of the image. We can also do that with zero key on the keyboard. Another great functionality is, since the images that are using the same code override are grouped, we can browse the gallery using this either arrow buttons or the arrow keys on the keyboard. As described in the article, you can easily create multiple galleries on the same page by duplicating the override and giving each copy a unique name and using that particular override for the same group of images. For our sample gallery, we just have a title, as you see, and four images in the stack, and the images were generated in Firefly. I've just uploaded images and resized them to be in 200 by 200 thumbnail size. To turn these static images into a lightbox gallery, we need to copy the lightbox gallery code override, like instructed in the article at pixcodedrops.com, which you'll find the link for in the description, as I said. Since I've already copied the code, I'll select the first image and click code overrides on the properties panel, open the dropdown next to file, click new file, enter lightbox for the title, and making sure new override is selected, which should be selected by default, I'm gonna click create and select the existing code, delete it, and paste the code that I've copied. I'm gonna save it, go back to home screen. You can see our lightbox code override here that we've just created on the assets panel. While the first image is still selected under code override, I'm gonna click the drop down next to file and select lightbox that I've just created. And for override, I will select with gallery. Now we can preview and test. As you see, our lightbox gallery works, but it works only for the first image since we haven't added the code override to other images. One issue we have here is actually not having the thumbnail image's border radius on hover, but there's an easy fix for that. Instead of trying to edit the code each time, we need to add a border radius. So before adding the lightbox override to all of the images, I will wrap each image in a separate frame and apply the border radius to the wrapper frame of each image. After doing that, I will select all of the wrapper frames and make their radius 20, same as the images. While we are at this screen, let's select all static images and add lightbox override to them. Now we can preview. As you see, the hover issue is fixed. And since we have multiple images in our gallery, there are also left and right buttons to browse our images, which we can do also with left and right arrow keys on the keyboard, as I said. Of course, you can edit some variables in the code to customize the colors and the size of the buttons. Actually, let's click edit code on the right panel, and you can see all lightbox settings are placed at the top for easy customization. To keep the tutorial shorter, I will leave them as they are. You can also see some information here about the attribution requirements. You are free to use this override in your both personal and commercial projects, but some attribution required, as I said, and details are written here, so you can check before using this override. As you see, this override can be great to create some quick gallery with thumbnails, with great features like zooming, etc., to add more functionality and usability to your designs. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope you liked it. If you want to see more, be sure to subscribe, turn the notifications on, check my other tutorials, and see you in the next one.